Shepherd of our soul, Shepherd of our soul,
Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up.
Father, we thank you, we bless you, we worship you. We magnify you because you are a good God.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for we are people that were rejected or that are still rejected by the world. In our rejection by the world, you selected us and you made us who we are today.
Amen.
Lord, we are grateful. We are thankful. Amen. Father, when we get to your kingdom, you will know how grateful we are.
Man,
we celebrate you now. No matter we express it, Father, we cannot really express it the way we should. But I tell you, Lord, in your mercy, when I and all your children on this mountain shall come to your heaven, when we start jumping up and down in your kingdom, when we start running, I know you will allow us to do whatever we want to do. Because that freedom we are crying for here now, where we shall come to you, eat and dine, touch those flowers, play with all everything in heaven, then you will know how appreciative we are. But right now, even in our limitation of earth here, we have come. We say, Father, we celebrate you.
Yes, Lord.
All that the devil is trying to do, to frustrate us, to afflict us, to make sure we are not who you want us to be. Lord, we say we take him to be nothing.
Amen.
Against all odds, we are here to glorify you, to celebrate you, to thank you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, we ask, oh God, that you speak your word to us, oh God.
Amen.
The word that will make us to really know what we are doing.
Amen.
Speak to me and speak through me.
Amen.
That I and every of your children on this mountain will become who you want us to be.
Amen.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Luke chapter number 22. Amen.
And
Luke chapter number 22, 15 down to 19. And he said unto them, I desire to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. Verse 16. For I say unto you, I will not anymore eat thereof until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God. 17. And he took the cup and gave thanks and said, take this and divide it among yourselves. Verse 18. For I say unto you, I will not drink of this fruit of the vine until the kingdom shall come. Verse 19. And he took bread and gave thanks and break it and gave it to them, saying, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. 20. Likewise, also the cup. After supper, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shared for you. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
The words of exhortation titled Celebrating in Remembrance of Your Eternal Freedom. Celebrating in remembrance of your eternal freedom. Celebrating Jesus Christ in remembrance of what he has done for you. Not temporary, for the eternal freedom he has given to you. Freedom that you and I never deserve. That's why he said, do it every day in remembrance of me. Brethren, the Bible told us in the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter number 6, verse 9 to 11. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Be not deceived. No, be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor adulterers, nor idolaters, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind. 10. Nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkard, nor railers, nor extortioner shall inherit the kingdom of God. Now, I want you to take your own out of there. Or maybe your own is not here. Take that sin that you were committing that would have made you not to be a part of God's kingdom. Point them out there and see where you were going to. Verse 11, and such were some of you. I come again. Know ye not the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Now, 11. And such were some of you, but ye are washed. How privileged are you? You and I, we are not having part in God's kingdom at all because of that sin that was in you. But thank God for Jesus. This is why we must do everything to celebrate him every time. And so, such were some of you, but ye are washed. But ye are sanctified. But ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. How privileged am I? I was among those that were walking to hell, but the Lord Jesus Christ watched me, purged me, that sin that was blinking before God. The Lord came and washed them away from me. That's why I must do everything to celebrate him every now and then. That's why I do this in remembrance of me, because I delivered you. I saved you from where you were on your way to. Brethren, all that was waiting for you and I was the wrath of God. We were living to face him on the last day. No matter the enjoyment we are enjoying now, the end point of our being was the wrath of God. But how are you sure you and I would have been able to get it? I don't think so. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Romans 1, verse 18. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness. You see what was revealed against us if not Christ, if not for what Christ has done. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men. You see, we were product of the wrath of God. If not that God, Jesus Christ, came to save us, who holds the truth in unrighteousness. And this is exactly the life you and I we are living before our redemption came. The only thing that the Lord was seeing in us was his wrath. Anytime he beholds me, behold you, it makes him angry. In whatever we are doing, boy, the anger of God waiting for you and I to come and drink it. But thank God somebody drank it for you and I. Brethren, we are told in Ephesians chapter 5 and 6, let no man deceive you with vain word. That's why we must be very, even in our redemption, we must be very careful. Let no man deceive you. For because of these things, because of those things they are telling you that the Lord has taken away already, that it took pain to take away, because of those things that make you to come. I said, I will not drink henceforth until it be fulfilled in my kingdom again. Right now, I desire to eat it, but because of what I'm about to do for you now, I will not drink it. I let me suffer it with hunger. Let me bear the pain in hunger. Because I know in hell, you can never eat again. So as I'm going to clean you, purge you, I want to suffer it completely so that you will know what I've done for you. Let no man deceive you with vain word. For because of these things, cometh the wrath of God. Because of, those things that the Lord has taken away from you. Because of that sin, the Lord has washed away. Because of that character, that behavior you and I possessed before. Upon the children of what? Of disobedience. But glory be to God, we are no more among them now. The grace of God, the mercy of God, have translated us from them to himself. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Romans chapter number 3, verse 3. Romans 3, 25. Romans 3, verse 25. Whom God has set for to be a propitiation through faith in his blood. Who is this? No other person than Jesus Christ. To declare his righteousness for the remission of sins that are past through the forbearance of God. All our past sin was taken away. He paid for them. He paid for my fornication. I was telling some of my people yesterday, sometimes I regret over things I have done before. I know it will be forgotten, it will be forgiven. But sometimes it pains me. Why did I even involve myself in all those things? Why should I make the Lord so? Why should I was making mockery of God. That's why we should be praying every day. All those things we did to God, that the Lord has forgiven us now, our children should not start from where we start from. All those fornication, all those lying, all those stealing, all those making mockery of God, so that our children will not start from where God stopped our own from. The prayer point, we must be praying. And the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Why should we keep celebrating it? Because he paid for the sin he knew nothing about. It became the propitiation of our sin to redeem us from the wrath of God. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
1 John chapter 2, verse 2. And he is the propitiation of our sins. And not of our sins only, but also of the sins of the world, of the whole world. Though the world have rejected it, though the world don't know, until they jump into that hole, they will never knew what God had done for them. But thank God for your life. Thank God for my life, that the Lord made us to understand what he has done for you. And whatever will make us to turn back our salvation tomorrow, may that thing be far from you and I forever in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But then we were still under condemnation when Christ showed forth. You and I were still under condemnation. We were judged and condemned when the Lord came. Tell me, what love will ever beat that? No love. Let a husband, God forbid, a husband say, tell your wife, hey, my dear, I'm sorry, okay? I'm so sorry. HIV. Hey, HIV! No. But the Lord took everything to himself. He knew we were afflicted. He knew we were condemned, yet he never said no. He still came and do it. He still came and did it for you and I. But my husband, I love him so much. I will die for you and you die for me. Okay. Sorry, I don't know. Maybe it was through needle, through syringe. I just went to go and do this, but they tell me, hey, you see, I will change now. Nobody can bear that body. When it comes to dying, then you know if the love is there. Nobody can ever die for anybody. But the Lord Jesus Christ did it for you. And he did it not that we have done anything for him. It's not because we loved him. In our hating him, he still loves us. How many of us here can love who is hating you? How many of us here? You know this person is hating you with chronic hatred. You still love the person. God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Romans chapter 6, from verse. Romans chapter 5, from verse 6. Romans 5, from verse 6 down. For when we were yet without strength, in due time, Christ died for you and I, your ungodly people. Verse 7. For scarcely for a righteous man we once die. Yet, peradventure, for a good man, some will even dare to die. I love this place so much. Was it our goodness that made Christ dare to die? No. See, peradventure, for good person, some people will say, okay, let me die. But what was that goodness in you? What was that good in me that made the Lord to come and die? Nothing. That's why we must do everything to celebrate him. But that's it. But God commended his love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Not when we were not righteous. Not when we were not good. When we were yet abusing him. When we were yet making mockery of him. He came and died for you and I. Now, much more then, be now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath through him. Everything, as I said before, that was waiting for you and I was the wrath of God. Now that we are now justified through his blood, he has suffered for us already. That's why, let me tell you something. Anybody that dies in sin, it makes the Lord more angry. God is more angry over anyone that dies in sin. You know why? But why will you go and suffer again the pain I've taken away from you already? Why will you allow yourself to go to hell? The hell I went for you already. That's why everyone on this mountain, no matter what the devil do, none of us shall defy the hell in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. For if, when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his son, much more, be reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. That's what Apostle Paul said, the life I now live, Galatians 5, verse 20, the life I now live, I live by the faith of the Son of God. That's why we must do everything to make sure the life we are now living is lived to his glory. The Lord help me, I help you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And not only so, verse 11, but we also joy in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we have now received the atonement. We have now received the freedom. We have now received the reconciliation. Everything that was between us and God is now pulled away. Glory be to God in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Brethren, our Lord and Savior was killed, not because of what he had done, but because of what you and I did. He was never a fornicator. He never stole. He never lied. No guy was found in him. But yet, he died. Some of us here, our parents that died 10 years ago. Let us go and celebrate him. Our brother, our loved one that died some years ago, we are doing his remembrance. What did the person do? Because he's just a brother. But this is somebody who died to save us. He still told us, do this in remembrance of me. The church is not doing it. But the one he never said, the one that when Apostle Paul is doing it, people come and contribute for him. They will start buying suits, buying shoes. That is the one we are doing. Christmas and whatever birthday they say they're doing. But the one he told us to be doing, go to the church today, they never do. May God have mercy upon the church in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Romans 4, verse 25. Who was delivered for our offenses and was raised for our justification. He was delivered to the Gentiles, to be mocked, to be humiliated, to be killed for our offenses. And glory be to God, on the third day, he resurrected and left our sin there. That's why you must not go there and pick it again. He left our sins in hell. Don't go to hell and pick them again. You and I have been justified. And whatever that is in me, in you, picking sin to us again, magnetizing sin as we eat him and drink it today, that thing shall be chased out of us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'll stop because time. Brethren, not by our strength, not by the work we have done, not by because I am an handsome man, not because you are a beautiful woman. Some Miss Words are in hell today. Miss Canada, Miss whatever, they are in hell today. But the Lord, His mercy, save you and I. Not because I am preaching. Not because you are paying tithe. That's why whenever we are praying, don't bring what you are doing before Him. Don't even try it. Oh Lord, you see, I'm a watchman. You see, I'm doing this. Don't even go there. If the Lord marked down for you, you are doomed. Just hang yourself on His mercy. Titus 3, 5 to 7. I'll stop here because time. Titus 3, 5 to 7. Not by works of righteousness. Not by works of righteousness, which we have done. Remember, Abraham said, our righteousness is like what? A filthy rag. Not just rag, a filthy one. But according to His mercy, He saved us. God, I thank you. By the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost, verses which He shed on us abundantly through Jesus our Lord. Verse 7. By being justified by His grace, we shall be made heir according to the hope of eternal life. Brethren, we are on this narrow way, not because of what you have done. And there's nothing you and I can ever do to merit it. It's all by the mercy of God. And nothing we are doing that we are doing, He is not doing them. So you get that? There's nothing we are doing that we are doing. He is the one doing His work by Himself. That's why He's so angry whenever we start thinking, I'm not doing this. We have no power to do anything. But the Lord does all things. Brethren, I want us to always celebrate Him, not only on the mountain, in our houses, wherever we go. Say, do this in remembrance of me. And I pray all this celebration will not end up in hell, but rather it will end up in His kingdom where you and I will celebrate Him forever and ever and ever and ever. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Be that you know that you did not deserve it. It's not by your strength. It's not by your power. It's all by the mercy of God. Why don't we go on our knees now or stand up as you can? See the place you are. It's conducive enough. But if you are in the office, please, they hire you for something. If you are in the office, please, the Lord will not hold you guilty. But that's what they are paying you for. You can just sit down and bend your head and do it there. Please, the Lord knows. But if the management can allow you to kneel down, no problem. But if not, don't worry about it. The Lord will not hold you guilty for it. For me, we that are at home, let's go on our knees. Let's thank Him. Let's bless His name. Let's celebrate Him. And let us tell Him, Father, give all the grace never to pick the sins you have taken from us again. Give us the grace to come and meet you in heaven on the last day. Anything that will make me to celebrate you on earth and go and start celebrating Satan in hell, let it be far from every one of us on this mountain.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, my Father and my God, Baba, Father, Lord, I beg you, anything, Baba, that will make me, Baba, Father, upon everything you have done for me, Baba, to come and start celebrating. Father, please, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Baba, Father, Lord, I beg you. Father, not anything, Baba, that will make me, Baba, Father, to come and start, oh God, Baba, celebrate after all that you have done for me, Baba, Father, please have mercy, Baba, Father, Lord, Baba, may that thing not come my God, Baba, in the name of Jesus, not my Baba, celebrate in the mighty name of God, everything, oh God, Baba, that will make me, Baba, Father, to start celebrating.
Jesus Christ, live. Pray.
Amen.
Pray for the mercy of people's foolishness. The Bible says, serve not any idol. Those who are celebrating birthday, you are celebrating that day you were born. You are indirectly serving that day you were born. Or no to you. And the one he said we should be doing, we are not doing it. You take yourself back and start serving the idol of that day. You don't even know what happened that day. Well, what is revealed to the babies? Those who take their wives, they don't know it. That's why the Lord Jesus Christ never did. No man of God, no apostle ever did it. But because of craftiness, people don't want to understand. Birthday. Birthday. Celebration, you are celebrating that day you were born. You are serving idol. Then people don't know. That's why on that day there'll be surprises. Nobody value Apostle Manuel, but no problem. When the time comes, they will know who is who. I want us to pray. All those things I used to celebrate before, making God to be jealous. He said, I am a jealous God. Celebrate me alone. What is in that day you are celebrating? David said, teach us to number our days that we might learn wisdom. But the children of God are celebrating a day. What is in that day that you are not celebrating? Lord, every celebration I've ever done that put you into jealousy, make you to be angry. Lord, have mercy upon me and deliver all those children of God that are serving God in ignorance, all his anger. Put him into jealousy, think they are serving him. Deliver them the way you open our eyes on this mountain. Also open their eyes, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and pray.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, the King of Kings, Baba, the Lord of all, Father, Lord, we pray for your master, Baba, for your children, Baba, Father, that has been celebrating birthday, Baba, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, please, oh God, Baba, open your eyes, oh God, Baba, the way you open your eyes, oh God, Baba, Father, please,
For you to understand, that's why even this one, do this in remembrance of me, it don't put one day. So that we don't attach any particular day to it and start celebrating idol unknowingly. He made us so that we can be good. As often as you eat it, you do show the lost death till you come. No day was attached to it. No month was attached to it. But today, children of God, I don't know. But I say, is it the same God that it is well? Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
I want us to pray. I say, Father, as you are teaching us every day, whatever that will make us by our own self to send ourselves to hell, just as our sister, Sister Lot's wife, did to herself, may we not do it to God. May we give us your hand to hold till we meet you in heaven. May we not drag our hands away from your hands, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, the King of Kings, Baba, the Lord of all, Father, whatsoever that will make us to God, Baba, to ourselves, O God, Baba, to ourselves, well, like Lord's wife, O God. Father, Baba, may that not come away, Baba, please come and hold our hands, O God, and come and walk this journey, Baba, with us, O God, Baba, until we enter your kingdom in the mighty name of Jesus, Baba. O God, Baba, please come and be our guide, come and hold our hands, O God, and come and walk this journey of life with us, your children, Baba, in the mighty name of Jesus.
My Father, in Jesus Christ, may we pray.
Amen.
Lastly, I want us to pray. Brethren, holiness is painful. I tell you the truth. Who is that person that don't everybody want to be celebrated? I want to know how much people love me. So this is my birthday. Let me see the people that will send gifts for me. I want to see people those who their suit will be better. I want to see those who we what. Because of holiness, it will take it away from you. That is the pain. I want to pray, Lord, every pain I need to bear to glorify you. Anything I need to lose for your sake in order to gain it in heaven. As I eat you today and drink you, just the way you bear your pain to rescue me, give me the grace to also bear those pain, those things I will lose. For your sake, I receive the grace to bear those pain in joy in the name of Jesus Christ. Open up the prayer.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, the King of Kings, Baba, the Lord of all, Father, please come and help me, Baba. Father, please, the grace to God, Baba, to bear whatsoever I need to bear, Baba, for you, Baba. Father, please come and help me, Baba. Father, the grace to God, Baba, to bear the pain of God. Father, Lord, whatsoever that I need to suffer. Father, please come, Baba. Father, please come, Baba. Help me to bear what you God.
Jesus Christ, may we pray.
Amen.
Lord, we open the eyes of his children to know the good he's doing for us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Are you out there? You're not born again. The Lord has spoken. Don't let your heart be troubled. Because, hey, in this kind of place I came today, this place that they don't do this thing, oh, it's for your own good. If you remember those things you used to do before, how shameful they are, you know what God has done for you. Please, I want you to surrender yourself to him. All those things you need to love before, there are burdens you don't know. In this ministry, the Lord, it takes burdens away from us. Remember those days when Christmas is coming, Sister Chidi, remember? Coming, oh, you'll be budgeting. But now the Lord has taken those burdens from you and I. Remember when your birthday is coming, those days, you'll be budgeting, inviting people. Oh, God, the Lord is taking those burdens away from us, but we don't know. It's not only about heaven. Even on earth here, we are enjoying it, but you don't know. Do you want to join us in this enjoyment? Your life to him. And move another step forward to be baptized. And the Lord will send the Holy Spirit upon you to enhance your joyful journey to heaven in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's set our table for the Holy Communion. Celebrating Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Oh, what it means to us since Jesus set us free, hanging on Calvary. Jesus' blood, oh, what a cleansing flow. He did it all for us on Calvary. Jesus' blood.
Praise the Lord. This is a mountain of solution and redemption prayer ministry worldwide, aka the Shepherd and the Bishop of Our Souls Ministry Worldwide.